The learning intention for this video is that we would understand static and dynamic equilibrium. In a previous video, we looked at reversible and irreversible reactions in open and closed systems. Now, reversible reactions that occur in a closed system can reach what we call equilibrium. An equilibrium reaction is one in which the rate of the forward reaction equals the rate of the reverse reaction. When a reaction is reversible and can reach equilibrium, we use this symbol instead of using an arrow in a chemical equation. So what is an equilibrium? Consider the following reaction. At first, the rate of the forward reaction is going to take place a lot faster than the reverse reaction because at the beginning of the reaction, there are more reactant particles than there are product particles. Once a particular concentration of the products is reached, however, the reverse reaction will start to take place. Once the rate of the forward reaction equals the rate of the reverse reaction, we say that equilibrium has been established. At this point, the concentrations of the reactants and the products do not change. They remain constant. For example, imagine walking up an escalator that's actually traveling downwards. If you walk at the exact same pace or the same speed as the escalator is going down, then you will remain in the same place. You're still walking up, but the escalator is moving down, but you remain in the same place. Equilibrium can only be established in a closed system. This is because in an open system, some of the reactants or products might be lost, or matter might be transferred into the system and disrupt the reaction. If a system is closed and it has reached equilibrium, we will not observe any changes in the macroscopic properties. So we should not see a change in color. We should not see a change in state. So we shouldn't see like a precipitate forming. We should not see a change in the amount of gas volume. And we should not observe any change in smell. There shouldn't be a sudden odor that comes from the system. There are two types of equilibrium, static and dynamic. A static equilibrium is when there is no movement between the reactants and the products. It is said that the reaction is at rest and the rate of that reaction, the forward and reverse reactions, is zero. An example of a static equilibrium is the conversion of carbon in the form of graphite to carbon in the form of diamond. While the reaction could be reversed, it reaches a point at which it will no longer continue and cannot be reversed unless large amounts of energy or pressure are applied. Diamond must be heated to approximately 2000 degrees Celsius before the reaction will reverse and convert the diamond back into graphite. So at room temperature, no diamond is being converted to graphite, or vice versa. This process is therefore at static equilibrium. The rate of the forward and reverse reactions are zero. A dynamic equilibrium is when the rate at which reactants are converting to products equals the rate at which products are converted back into the reactants. And this is happening constantly in the system. An example of a dynamic equilibrium is a sealed bottle of soft drink. The rate at which the carbon dioxide escapes the solution is equal to the rate at which it dissolves back into the solution. So here I've got my bottle of soft drink, a zero sugar one because I'm healthy like that. And this is a dynamic equilibrium. It's a closed system. The seal hasn't been broken. It's a closed system. And it's dynamic because the rate of the forward reaction and reverse reactions are the same. So constantly in this soft drink bottle, there is reactions going on. So just try and get the color right. Okay, so you can see at the top here, we've got the gas. There's space for the gas here. And we've got the liquid. Now what's constantly happening is that the carbon dioxide gas is being dissolved into the water, into the solution to make a carbonic acid. But the rate at which that is happening is exactly the same as that carbon dioxide gas being released back out of the liquid. And so those two reactions are happening at the same rate within this bottle. Now, if we were to open this bottle, then the equilibrium will be disturbed. If we were to seal it again, it would re-establish an equilibrium. I hope this video has helped you to understand static and dynamic equilibrium. In an upcoming video, we are going to look at Le Chatelier's principle and how equilibrium can be disturbed.